Azure has a pricing calculator. That pricing calculator is actually really good. AWS has a pricing calculator. It is pretty good. I like Azure's pricing calculator a lot, except that you kind of have to understand how the calculator works to get to understand how the calculator works. It's sort of pretty complex to get started with. And we'll try to disambiguate it a little bit tonight as well. So how much is my stuff going to cost? I mean, that is kind of the ultimate question. Well, as I mentioned, the pricing calculator, which if you've not been to this site before, is a very useful site. You will have your cloud solutions architects at Microsoft. They will use this calculator. The salespeople will use the calculator. Microsoft partners, so third-party companies, organizations that work with customers to help land them on Azure, will use this calculator. Not everything is in the calculator. For example, if you say, I want to have Power BI for my employees, Power BI is not included in this pricing calculator. There is no option to say, I want to enable Power BI premium SKUs, or I want to have premium per user. There's nothing in there for Microsoft 365. There are a lot of Microsoft cloud services that are not part of the Azure pricing calculator. So your total expenditure might actually be higher depending on what you want to do and essentially what services you wish to have. This includes everything which is in Azure itself and Power BI Online, M365, that kind of stuff. Even though it is tied very closely in with the Azure world, not everything in there is, strictly speaking, Azure itself. When it comes to cloud providers, everything's got a price. If you want to bring data into them, that's actually, usually it's free. And at the extreme, if you have an enormous amount of data, Microsoft will ship you drives. They will ship you hard drives. You can load up the hard drives. You ship them back. They'll even pay for the shipping. Getting your data out, now you pay. So Hotel California, you can go in for free. You're not getting out otherwise. It's free to put that data in there. But if you actually want to have it stay in there, you got to pay for that. You want to use that data, well, you have to pay for the compute to actually process any data. And of course, you have to pay for network utilization. I mean, that's not free, especially if you have network utilization transiting between different regions. That's certainly not free. If you want high availability, you want to make sure that your data is actually available when you need it. But you usually have to pay a little bit extra for that. Oh, if you want things faster, you can pay more for that too. You can usually always pay more money to get something. And if you're running this in a dev or test environment, you kind of have to pay. There are some services that are free, that have free tiers, but most services, you're going to pay something. Is this current and accurate summary for a variety of Azure cloud services? Yep. Like I said, we'll talk about where dev and test can be cheaper or it can be free. But generally, almost every service, as soon as you're in, you're paying for all of these different categories. And we'll see where some of this pricing comes from and how you can calculate that over the course of the talk tonight.